Let's go ahead and get the pay-per-view prediction video out of the way. This is WWE, over the limit, under arrest. That's right. You know you're over the limit when you start crossing over the median. You know you're swerving. And I believe the limit is .08 in most states. Alright, we got 8 matches on the card, and I'm going to try my best to randomly pick a winner. We got R-Truth versus Ted DiBiase in a opener match thing. Virgil might be in the corner. That's what Ted DiBiase said. Obviously, they're building up DiBiase. And I don't know. He's going kind of with his old dad's gimmick. Can't lose with that. And R-Truth does backflips. DiBiase will probably win to further build his character, though you're not really building your character by beating R-Truth. I mean, they could have just done this on a Superstar, so whatever. Should be an alright match, though. Eve vs. Maryse for the Divas title in what some may call a bathroom break match. It will be short and probably not too interesting. Eve's kind of filled in the slot of Melina while she's gone. Till Melina gets back and probably beats up Eve or something. Although to Eve's credit, she can fight. They just won't let her, you know, use her Brazilian in ninjutsu skills. Got the Heart Dynasty versus Jericho. Jericho and The Miz. I really want the Heart Dynasty to keep the belts. This rivalry, I think, will go at least till SummerSlam, I'm guessing, no matter who wins. I hope. Hopefully, no matter what, the Heart Dynasty does not get buried. But once again, I want them to retain. And I want some traditional tag teams to come back in the WWE. Not this just random... Well, for the most part, it's just been like random main eventers just kind of thrown together. Which, at first, was cool. You know, Jericho and Edge, hey, that was cool. And then it became Jericho, Big Show, and then, you know, continued Big Show, Miz upper mid-carder, and then Miz, Jericho. It's just like, switch them out. People like Crime Time, of course, never won the tag titles, but at least they were more of a traditional tag team. Whatever happened to the tag teams that were booked as brothers? You know, the Dudley Boys, or the cousin things, like the Godwins. Let's go back to that. Got Randy Orton versus Edge in a winner doesn't really gain anything match, really. Either one could win or either one could lose, and they'd still get, you know, the same portion of the audience would cheer or boo them. I will go with... I'll go with Edge. Rey Mysterio vs. CM Punk with Straight Edge Society Pride at ringside. And then Joey Mercury. I'm surprised they haven't really showed off him a lot. Supposedly he's like a member of the Straight Edge Society, but not really. Like he just randomly runs in every other week or something. So I'm going with Rey Mysterio losing, joining the Straight Edge Society, and like a lot of other people here on YouTube have said, I will follow suit like a lemming and say that by SummerSlam, Rey Mysterio will be like, alright, if I beat you, the Straight Edge Society, you know, disbands. But if you beat me, then, I don't know, I'm still in the Straight Edge Society. I don't know why he'd agree to that. But I could be wrong, maybe, you know, I can't see Rey Mysterio winning again. That's just burying Punk. Although, without his hair, he'd look horrible. Drew McIntyre vs. Kofi Kingston in the IC title match. I don't see why Kofi Kingston couldn't be the reigning champ and then just have Drew McIntyre attack him and kind of steal the belt. The whole stealing the belt, I'm really the rightful champ gimmick. Not gimmick, but kind of storyline. Instead, Drew McIntyre just like showed a piece of paper and just kind of was handed the belt back. And I guess, I mean, either which way builds a feud. It was just kind of a waste of time having a tournament. The matches were good, but the tournament... How can you call it a tournament when there's like 4 guys? Doesn't a tournament usually have at least, you know, 3 rounds? I mean, what, there are 4 guys involved. So not really a tournament. Jack Swagger versus The Big Show. For the World Heavyweight title, Jack Swagger is retaining. I'm surprised The Big Show hasn't had a 3 or 4 month reign with any title, really. They always give him these like 1 month reigns, maybe. And he's good on the mic. He's solid for a big man. Heck, he's better than half these people they put, you know, the title on. I mean, he's better than Sheamus. And was better than Sheamus, but they're like, Sheamus is different because he's really pale. Give him the belt. John Cena vs. Batista in a, when I lose, I'm going to go make movies, and I'm really tired of having to, you know, go to the airport and make a show. And I definitely don't do house shows. Match. The writing's on the wall. Batista's losing. This is the end of the feud, and pretty much probably the end of his WWE run. So I did make a Batista tribute. Let's watch.
Back it up. Now count.
I hate you,
Batista.
I hate you, too. The official.
I tell you, it brings a tear to the eye. No more man panties. No more Dave Wrinkly Head Batista. But in all honesty, you know, he did put his body through lots of pain to, I'm sure he entertained somebody somewhere. So, Batista, I salute you for sacrificing your body. Cena's gonna win. You know what I hate about these I quit matches with Cena? Actually, you know what I just hate about Cena? Is that I don't think he's ever tapped, even like in post-match beatdowns. And I know they gotta make him really strong and tough. But like Austin, Rock, I know, here come the comparisons. But I'm basically, Cena's like never tapped in any situation. So that doesn't even make him realistic. I mean, even, you know, like people like Hogan and Bret Hart, you know, they've tapped in matches before, whether they were I quit. You know, it may have been a post-match beatdown, but you'd see, oh, they do have a pain threshold. You know, they look more human. Cena never looks like a realistic wrestler. Like everyone says, he's too Superman-ish. It's like, Cena, you can occasionally, you know, once a year tap or once a year sell a move better. Because you'll get, like, a power bomb, and then the guy will turn around and, you know, you'll do your little shoulder tackle and an F5, and I know you're supposed to be a hero to everybody. And I know Austin and Rock kind of, Brett and Flair and any big name you can say kind of did the power up where they'd get a finishing move done to them and get up kind of quick. But you do it consistently and you need to stop. I know you're the poster boy, but I'm not going to knock too much of your skill, but that's what I've definitely noticed throughout your 5 years of main eventing. You just don't like selling finishing moves half the time. You'll just get up and you just don't look realistic. You look like a caricature of what a wrestler should be. Be a little more realistic. Stop being all cartoony and, oh, I'm going to power up no matter what. Sorry. So yeah, that's WWE Over the Limit Under Arrest pay-per-view predictions. That is what I think, and have a good week.